Out the week that was in politics, New York Times political correspondent Jeff Zeleny and CNN senior congressional correspondent Dana Bash. I want to start by putting a period on the story that you wrote this week, which is the consideration of a proposal by a super PAC that would bring up Reverend Wright again, time to go with the Democratic convention. In all the aftermath of that, did someone win on this and someone lose, or is this just another one of those summer squalls?
I think it's a summer squall, but it really shows that this is not potentially good for either campaign. The Romney campaign wants to talk about the economy, and they have a bunch of potential renegade super PAC and wealthy Republicans who mean well, who want the same outcome, but they're not on the same message, perhaps. And for President Obama, of course, independent voters may find it a bit distasteful to bring up a Reverend Wright, but we did talk about Reverend Wright again this week, so it's not necessarily a win for him either, but it just sends the message that the campaigns are not in control of their election.
Oh, big time. I mean, you look at Romney's first ad this week. It was positive. It was really on the issues, what he would do on day one. You know, it might be a little bit too cute by half in that he can do that, and he can still have sideshows talking about things like Reverend Wright. Whether or not they're going to put out an ad or not, he can, you know, distance himself, but it's still in the narrative.
And with respect to the chairman, this was a plan and a proposal. This was far down the track, though. This was not just an idea floating out there. This proposal that we obtained, it was pretty far in the discussion phases.
And very quickly after the story appeared was nobody's plan.
Absolutely.
And let's face it, the Democrats are, I mean, despite what David said, they were fundraising on it, saying,
no question,
oh, my gosh, they're coming after us, holy cow, when in fact nothing had happened.
Right.
So it was good for both bases, do you think?
I mean, perhaps in the short term, but again, I just think it shows that neither campaign is really in as much control of this election as they would like. I mean, there are these outside forces that want to spend a lot of money, and a lot of consultants who are eager to spend their money for them.
And the Republicans do make a good point that anytime the Obama administration is not talking about the economy, if they're attacking the Republicans for attacking them, that's okay with
that. That's a good thing. I want to play you something that Marco Rubio, often thought of as possibly on a shortlist for vice president, but certainly a star in the Republican Party, had to say last night in South Carolina.
The strategy that this White House and his party is employing is a destructive one that pits Americans against each other. Rich versus poor. Men versus women. Never have we seen such an effort to divide the American people in an effort to win an election as we have seen today.
So as I said, when we get to the superlatives and never, we are really heavy into an election season, a general election season, which seems to me to have started nasty and early.
It doesn't feel like it's May, does it? If you get the feel of things like that. I think the beginning of what he said, he might have, you know, had a point. I mean, there's no hiding the fact that the campaign strategy in Chicago, the Obama world, is the populist message and the war on women. The fact that it's more than ever in history, maybe that's a little stretching a little bit.
Yeah, perhaps in the history since he's been in the Senate, which is only a couple of years.
5 minutes.
I want to also try to put a period on one other issue that came up last week, and that is the president's personal support for gay marriage. This is something we saw the NAACP, first of all, come out yesterday and say we also support gay marriage as a civil right, which is very important to President Obama because there were those in the African American community
Absolutely.
Who were not supportive. So for have this big prestigious group come out and say we're with him is great. And this is what Newt Gingrich had to say yesterday.
It's unfortunate that he's so political, but it eliminates any attack on Romney about ever flip-flopping when you have Obama flip-flopping on something that big and doing it immediately after the people of North Carolina voted no. It's almost like he was insulting the people of North Carolina.
So he's talking about the fact that the president came out with his personal support for gay marriage, even as North Carolina was saying, no, we're against it. Net gain or net loss for President Obama or net we don't know?
I think we don't know yet. But there's no question that the NAACP support for this is very important. It gives this president and vice president a lot of cover among some black leaders and pastors and things. But we still don't know how this will affect the campaign in states like Ohio, these working class voters who may not be as far along on this issue as the national polls are.
That's true. But if you just look at the way Republican leaders reacted to his change, the president's change, the fact that they stood back and they didn't want to touch it, they don't know. They think it might be a wash because it's a 50-50 issue. So
Right. And it also depends, even if it's a 50-50 issue, it depends on who actually votes only on
exactly.
that. So
that's
you
right.
never, that's the other
which
unknown.
Is not so a high number.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. I'm sorry. It's so short. Come back. Jeff Zeleny doing that.
Thanks,
thank
Andy.
You guys. President Obama's